Internal measures to prevent corruption. 6 practical steps. Step 2. Assess. An interview with Carolina Echevarria, Supervisor, German-Argentinian Chamber of Industry and Commerce. What is your understanding of assessment in the light of a corruption prevention program?
Well, I think the assessment is the heart of the prevention corruption program. I think for the small and medium companies especially, they have to focus, they don't have a lot of money and they have to focus their money in what is important. So if you don't make a risk assessment, you can start working in compliance issues that you really don't have. So it's really important to take the time to make the assessment. All the companies are risk and they are not essentially a bad thing. But the most important or the most big risk is not to see the risk. So when you make a risk assessment, you can use your money more efficiently and you can work in the things that really matters, no, for your own company. There is no one risk assessment equally for each company because every company has different risk.
How can risks be assessed within a company?
Well, that's a good question. It's the hard part of the whole risk assessment. First of all, for making a risk assessment, you have to know really deeply your company. So you have to know which are your business partners, which are your main activities, in which part of the world are you working. If you don't know deeply your company, you can't make a real good risk assessment. So the risk can come from the outside. For example, if you are in a place where it's a poor law enforcement, there you have an external risk, and also the risk could be internal. For example, if you have a sales department with a huge budget. So once you know that the risk came from outside or inside, you are going out there to find the risk in your own company. And then again, you can find an internal source, talking with the people, you're auditing informs for last years, or you can also find it an external source. The usual risk in your brand or the usual risk in this country or another country. Once you have this, you have to make a rank of the risk because you have to work only in the most important risk for you. So an easy way to do it is like putting a number for each risk. If one risk is really probably to happen, you put a high number. And also, if this risk has a big impact in your company, you put also another big number. And you can multiply these numbers and then you have a rank of all the risk that you have. Once you have this and you order your risk, you can start really taking the measures to work against this risk, to minimize them, to eliminate them, or to translate them to a third party, to insurance or another institution.
Please share a best practice or lessons learned example.
Well, because I am coming from Argentina, I will tell a story about an Argentinian company. It's also a small and medium company, 100 employees, so a small company. They took a lot of time to make the risk assessment, a half a year, that's a lot for a company that is starting to implement a compliance program. The compliance program was implemented by the law department because they don't have enough money to make an own compliance department. And they were doing something like this. They were, first of all, meeting with all the departments, with each department. They go through the whole process one by one, so 3 or 4 hours with each department, with the manager, but also with the people that are working in this department. And they, with the persons of the department, they make the list of the risk. Once they end to make the risk of everyone, they start to make like a multi-department risk group. So they, with other departments, analyze the risk that they found in the other departments. For example, the human resources departments were looking for risk in the sales departments. And they found risk that the sales departments were not seeing this risk. Because if you are making an activity every day, you maybe don't think that this is a risk. and other departments can see it like that. And once they finish, they really implement one of the best compliance programs in the regions, and they are known in Argentina and in other countries as a transparent example and as a transparent program. So the key of this success of the compliance program were really a good risk assessment.